Peter Pan by J M Barrie, dramatized by Philip Glassborough.
She's saying hello out of the window.
Is someone there, Mother?
No, Wendy, no one. I thought I saw a face at the nursery window.
It must have been the window cleaner.
Nana, what window cleaner?
John, how could it have been a window cleaner? We're three floors up.
Well, perhaps he's got a very long ladder.
I know, Wendy. Perhaps he was in a balloon.
That is the last chance.
Come on now, Michael. No, Nana, I won't be bathed. You needn't think it. Oh, come on then.
Here you are, Mary. In the nursery at a time like this?
Maybe he was a burglar.
What's the matter, George, dearest?
Matter? Matter? This tie is the matter. Tie, did I say? It will not tie. Not round my neck. Round the bedpost, oh yes, 20 times have I made it up round the bedpost, but round my neck, oh dear no, begs to be excused.
Oh dear no, begs to be excused. Say it again, Father.
Michael. A little less noise there. Michael, go and be bathed at once, sir.
I have been.
Huh? Well then.
George.
I warn you, Mary, unless this tie is round my neck, we don't go out to dinner tonight. And if I don't go out to dinner tonight, I never go to the office again. And if I don't go to the office again, you and I starve and our children will be thrown into the streets.
Oh, no.
What, Father? Thrown into the streets? Let me try, George.
You can try, by all means, but it won't do any good. Not a bit of it.
There now.
You cut a rather handsome figure, eh?
No, don't jump up now. George.
Come on, you old clumsy, clumsy dog. Mary, look, my best trousers covered with dog hairs. It's too bad.
Here, let me brush you down, George. Nana, put the children to bed now, will you? Where is Michael's teddy? Does anyone know?
Nana.
Come along, that's time for bed.
I sometimes think, Mary, it's a mistake to have a dog for a nanny.
But Nana is a treasure and so economical.
No doubt, no doubt. But I have an awful feeling at times she looks upon the children as puppies.
We must keep Nana, George. I will tell you why. When I came into this room tonight, I saw a face outside this window.
A face at the window? Three floors up?
A boy trying to get in. George, it was not the first time I've seen that boy.
Oh?
The first time was a week ago, and the boy was in the room.
In the room?
I screamed, and just then Nana ran in and sprang at him. The boy jumped out of the window. Nana pulled down the sash quickly, but it was too late to catch him.
Was she indeed? You see, that's what comes of having a dog for a nurse.
Wait, George. The boy escaped, but his shadow had no time to get out. Down came the window and cut it clean off.
Huh? Cut off? His shadow?
Yes.
Yes. Mary, if only you'd kept that shadow.
But I did. I rolled it up carefully and put it in this drawer.
Good grief.
Here it is, you see. It's really quite an ordinary shadow.
Ordinary shadow. Well, it's nobody I know, but he does look a scoundrel.
Oh, don't you see, George? He's bound to come back for it. Nana wanted to leave it hanging out of the window for him to collect, but it did look so like the washing.
Back in the drawer it goes, Mary. I shall take it to the British Museum first thing tomorrow morning and have it analysed.
George, the boy was not alone that first time. He was accompanied by, I don't know how to describe it, by a, A ball of light, not as big as my fist, which darted about the room like a living thing.
Curiouser and curiouser. Did it escape with the boy?
Yes. Oh, George, what can all this mean?
What indeed?
What?
Oh, they're in bed now, thank you, Nana. I'll come and say goodnight to them. Good Nana. Lovely Nana. Oh, but don't jump up on Mr. Darling, Nana.
Don't lick me, you silly dog. I can't hear myself think with all your woofing.
George, not so loud. The servants will hear you.
Let them hear. Bring in the whole world. I refuse to allow that dog to lord it in my nursery for 1 hour longer.
George, dear, Nana's trying to say sorry.
Yes, and covering me with dog hairs again. Come along, Nana. In vain, the proper place for a pooch is in the yard, and there you go to be chained up this instant. Come, out, out, out.
But, George, couldn't Nana sleep in the nursery tonight with the children? Remember what I told you about that boy.
Am I to be master in this house, or is she? Now come along, you recalcitrant canine.
Poor Nana.
Shh, Michael. Try to be brave, my dears. Where are the matches for the night lights? Oh, there.
She sounds awfully unhappy.
That's not Nana's unhappy bark. That's her bark when she smells danger.
Danger?
Why are you looking out of the window, Mother? Is there anything there?
No. No, all is quiet and still. Oh, how I wish I wasn't going out to dinner tonight. But we'll only be up the road at number 27, and Liza's downstairs in the scullery if you need her.
Nothing can harm us, Mother, after the night lights are lit.
Nothing, precious. They're the eyes a mother leaves behind her to guard her children. Sleep sweetly, have sweet dreams, and God bless you.
Good night, Mother.
Good night, my own one. Sleep sweetly.
Good night.
Good night, John. Sweet dreams.
How did you get to know me, Mother?
Close your eyes now, Michael.
But what time was I born at?
2 o'clock in the night time.
Oh, Mother, I hope I didn't wake you.
Dear little Michael, off to sleep now. Sleep sweetly, have sweet dreams the whole night through. Good night.
Back on straight away before I lose you again. Here's some sticky stuff. One stick.
Boy?
Oh!
Why are you crying?
Huh? How do you do? How do you do? Yes. What's your name?
Wendy Moira Angela Darling.
What's yours? Peter Pan.
Where do you live?
Second to the right, straight on till morning.
Oh. Is that what they put on the letters?
Don't get any letters.
But your mother gets letters.
Don't have a mother.
Oh, Peter! No wonder you were crying.
I wasn't crying.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.